Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to control servo motor with 555 timer IC. Here we'll see how PWM signal controls the servo motor. So let's get started. To control servo motor with 555 IC, we need to connect 555 in Astable mode so that it can generate PWM signal, because we know that servo motor is controlled by PWM signal. So this is the circuit, the 555 in Astable mode. I have explained this circuit in my previous video, link in the description below. And this one is C, this one R1, this one R2. Now see this. This is the output of 555. As I have explained in previous video, this is the total time period, and this one we call T on, and this time period we call it T off. As given in the data sheet of servo motor, it is given that the servo motor give response if the T on time is less than 2 milliseconds and higher than 1 millisecond. I'm talking about this time period, okay? So we have to generate a PWM signal by 555 which having T on between 2 milliseconds to 1 millisecond. In the data sheet, it is given that for 1 millisecond, the position of the rotor is in 0 degree, and for 2 millisecond T on time, the position of the rotor in 180 degree. We know that servo motor can rotate from 0 degree to 180 degree. We'll see this thing in the oscilloscope, okay? Now let's come to the calculation part. I have taken R1 equal to 10 kilo ohms, R2 as 10 kilo ohms, and C equal to 50 nanofarad. And our potentiometer value is 100 kilo ohms. As we know from the previous video, the output of the 555 is high whenever this capacitor is in charging condition, and the output of 555 is off whenever the capacitor is in discharging condition. Now see this. We have to calculate only the on time. The capacitor charges by this voltage, current flow through this way, through this R1 and through this diode, because there will not be any current flow because this side is cathode and this side is anode. In this diode, this side is anode. So current will flow through this diode and through this potentiometer. For the calculation, we will consider this potentiometer instead of R2. Current is flowing only through R1 and the potentiometer. Okay. As we know, T on equal to 0.693 multiplied by R1 plus, here it is potentiometer instead of R2, okay, and multiplied by C. R1 equal to 10 kilo ohms plus, as potentiometer is 100 kilo ohms, so we'll take only two values of it. First we'll take the minimum value, that is 0 ohms, and second time we'll take 100 kilo ohms, and we'll calculate the T on time, and the capacitance is 50 nanofarad. So we can write it as 0.693 multiplied by 10,000 ohms multiplied by 50 nanofarad, means 10 to the power minus 9 farad. Okay, so we can write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we are getting the answer as 0.000 3465. The unit is in seconds, okay, and it is equal to 0.346 millisecond. Okay, so this is the minimum T on time. Now calculate the maximum T on time. 693 multiplied by R1, that is 10,000 ohms, plus, as this time our potentiometer value is, I am taking the maximum potentiometer value, that is 100 kilo ohms, and multiplied by capacitance, that is 15 nanofarad. We are getting it as 0.38115 and it will be 3.811 millisecond. Okay, so by this circuit we are getting the minimum T-on time as 0.346 millisecond and maximum T-on time 3.811 millisecond. Now let's see the breadboard connection. Put the 555 IC. Pin number 1 is connected to ground. Pin number 4 is connected to plus VCC. Pin number 8 also is connected to plus VCC. Both the positive power rails also connect both the negative power rails. 10 nanofarad or 0.01 microfarad capacitor is connected to pin number 5. Then it is connected to ground. 10 kilo ohm resistor is connected between pin number 7 and 8. Now put two diodes here. 10 kilo ohm resistor between two diodes. 100 kilo ohms potentiometer. This side is connected to pin number 7. Pin number 6 and 2 both are connected together. Middle pin of potentiometer is connected to pin number 2 and 6. I have connected it to pin number 2. One end of potentiometer is connected to this diode. Another end is connected to another diode. Okay. Now see this. As we know, we need 15 nanofarad capacitor. So I'll connect 200 nanofarad capacitor in series. Okay. And its equivalent will be 50 nanofarad. 100 nanofarad, that means 0.1 microfarad, or in the capacitor it is written as 104. Now see the calculation. As we know, the equivalent capacitance of two capacitor is equal to 1/C1 plus 1/C2. As both the capacitor value is 100 nanofarad, so 100 square, and here it is 2 multiplied by 100. So this 100 and the square got cancelled out. 2/100, it means 50. Okay, so 1/C equal to 1/50, so C equal to 50 nanofarad. Okay, now I'm connecting both the capacitor in series. One end is connected to pin number 2, another end is connected to ground. Now it's time to connect our servo motor. So this is the servo motor I'm going to use. The model number is SG90. Okay, and these are the pins. Okay, so it having 3 pins. The first one is orange, the middle one is red, and the third one is brown. The orange pin is for input PWM signal. The middle one, that is red one, is for plus VCC, and the ground is connected to last pin, that is brown pin. Okay. The ground and the VCC pin is connected here. And the signal pin is connected to pin number 3 of IC555. Okay, now see this. So whenever I rotate this potentiometer, our servo motor will rotate. Okay, now this potentiometer is in minimum position. So it is in 0 degree. Now see this. So this is how we can control servo motor with 555 IC. As you can see here, it is rotating complete 0 to 180 degree. Now let's see this thing in the oscilloscope to know the actual tion time which is responding by this servo motor. For that, I have to connect the oscilloscope to the signal pin of it. Okay, as you can see, I have connected to signal pin and ground pin of it is connected to ground. Okay, now see this. I have kept its position to 0 degree, and as you can see here, it is 410 microsecond, that is 0.41 millisecond. As we have found, the minimum tion time is 0.346 millisecond, but we are getting here 0.41 millisecond. Okay, now I'll increase the tion time. And our servo motor is responding up to, it is 3 millisecond. But after that, if I increase to 4 millisecond, it is not responding. Now I am decreasing. It is responding from 2.5 millisecond. Okay. See both the oscilloscope and the servo motor. So with this, we have got the actual tion response for this servo motor. Okay. So guys, this is all for today. I hope you like this video. If so, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubt on this, then please let me know in the comment section. In the next video, I'll come with new topic. Till then, stay happy and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.